Welcome to our video on using desktop EndNote for a systematic review. In this video we'll look at setting up your library ready for your systematic review, downloading references, deduplication, and then two stages of screening, both title and abstract and full text, so that you can successfully complete the Prisma diagram shown on the right, which you need to record the filtering process when you're doing a systematic review. When you're doing a systematic review, you need a completely empty EndNote library. So first of all, go to Create a new library by going to File and New. Once you've done that, create some groups. One for each database you will be searching, and then groups that will help you with filtering your results. So you need an include group, an exclude group, a final selection and a final rejection group. If you need more support with creating groups, take a look at our other video, Desktop EndNote 3, Organising and Editing References. The next step is to get the references into your library. And first of all, you need to finalise your search strategy. So make sure you've got all the keywords that you need, that you're happy that your search is as comprehensive as possible. You may also need to adapt your search for each database you're searching, so have a look at the help screens on that database to see if there's anything you need to change with your search strategy. Once you're happy, run it on each database and download the results into EndNote. And as you download from each database, put those references into the relevant group that you've created for that database. Make sure when you're downloading from databases that you download the abstract. This will help you with the filtering process. And make a note of the numbers. So once you've downloaded the references from all of your databases, make a note of the number you downloaded from each database and also the total number in your library. If you need help with getting references into EndNote and how you download from databases, please take a look at our Desktop EndNote 2 video, which will help you with this process. Once you've got all your references into your library, the first thing to do is to deduplicate, because the same article or reference may have come up on multiple databases. EndNote has an automated tool, so just go to the Library menu in EndNote and select Find Duplicates. This will take you through comparing each of the duplicates so you can choose which one to keep. So things to compare, things like sort of journal names, are they in full or are they abbreviated? So you'd select the one that had the journal name in full. It's not a perfect tool though, so once you've used that, just also manually scan through your references. So just sort on author and go through and look for any duplicates that are still there and move them into trash. Once you've finished doing that, make a note of the number that's left in your All References group and also the total number that you've moved to trash, because you'll need to record that in your Prisma diagram. After deduplicating, you then need to start looking at each reference in turn to judge whether it's relevant or not. So read the title and abstract and judge whether it meets your inclusion criteria. If it does, add it to your include group. If it doesn't, put it in your exclude group. And if you're not sure, just put it in your include group for now, and you can make a final decision when you look at the full text. So once again, make a note of some of the numbers. So you will need the total number in all references, which would go in the records screened box on your Prisma diagram. The records excluded would be the total number in your exclude group. And the reports sought for retrieval would be the number in your include group. You can now concentrate on the references that are in your include group, and you need to try and get the full text. EndNote has an automated Find Full Text tool, which works best if you're on campus, which you can use to try and get the PDFs. So just highlight all of the references in your include group and go to the Find Full Text button. It will then search and will attach as many PDFs as it can, or it may well give you a link which may take you to the full text. Any that it doesn't find and attach automatically, you could try searching for the article titles on the Library's Discovery Service Summon and on Google Scholar to see if you can download the PDFs from there. And if you can, you can then manually attach that PDF to the right reference in your library, so you can quickly see from the paperclip attachments in EndNote which ones are missing. Have a look at the ones that you haven't been able to get. Judge whether they are actually key for your study. Have a look at things like the number of pages. Sometimes you may get a reference which is just an abstract of a meeting, a conference paper, which will only be a page long. There is no point requesting these, trying to get a hold of them. Any that you do need, we can usually get for you from the British Library and other libraries in the UK via our interlibrary loan service. So just fill in the request form, and it usually just takes a couple of days for the PDF to be emailed to you. You can now start reading the full articles and judging them against your inclusion criteria again. And the ones that you think are relevant still, move into your final selection group. The ones that aren't relevant, you can put in your final rejection group, but you should note the reasons why you rejected them at this stage. So in the EndNote record, there is a research notes field that you could use to record the reasons why you rejected them, because you will need to record this in your Prisma diagram. So those are the key steps for using desktop EndNote for your systematic review and for filtering through and getting the final numbers that you need to record in your Prisma diagram. If you need further help, we have a desktop EndNote guide and videos. There's also a guide to doing a systematic review if you need some support with the rest of the process. And you can, of course, contact your academic liaison librarian if you'd like some personal help with your review.